As a new day begins at IMRE, we see an organization defined by the people held closely in its heart. A heart powered by the passion and brilliant minds of over 400 talented researchers and scientists, currently a pillar of material research both in Singapore and the global science community. Now, IMRE is home not only to groundbreaking research, but to a family of collaborators and innovators who have grown together, each with their own unique experiences.
Full of opportunities.
Amazing.
Family.
Continuous learning.
Fascinating.
Uplifting.
But what was IMRE before the sun rose on the place we call home today? In 1997, a few remarkable people believed that greater material research had the power to improve lives in Singapore. In a tiny lab at Kent Ridge, they had a dream. Although these young budding scientists perhaps didn't realize how important IMRE would become.
Materials research in Singapore in the 1990s was budding. I saw the need for a different approach to materials research in an environment conducive to collaborative research among faculty, scientists, and engineers, and to discovery and engineering ingenuity, facilitated by centralized state-of-the-art facilities. So the challenges of the 1990s created opportunity to do something new and different, and I hope transformational as well, the formation of IMRE.
I wanted to build IMRE into a world-class research institute devoted to materials research. So that was a pretty daunting task. There wasn't a culture. I think people didn't necessarily identify with IMRE. So my first challenge was to do team building. They had to act like they were a team and forget where they came from, that we have this mission, that we need to move together toward the same goal.
哦, Lisa is myself in 1998.
This me, mm-hmm. In IMRE's 10th anniversary dinner, 2007. I joined IMRE in 2000, oh. Before the official launch of the building.
Okay, so I joined in 1997, January, so 3 years before you.
For IMRE, okay. Right, I feel that different people, but the culture is almost the same. So there's not much of the ranking for me, at least. So at my level, everybody feels like we are all the same. So we work together in a team. We didn't really rank ourselves. So the culture, the bonding, the company spirit, this is what I feel.
I still in IMRE about 25 years. I think I can contribute to the IMRE, and I'm happy to make a contribution.
When I joined, I was just fresh grad. The cohesiveness of the people makes me stay around. Oh, back then, we do have a lot of social events. I'm not sure whether you remember. So because we have a rooftop, we have barbecue, we have
happy hour. Yeah, we have people every day.
Every day. So we have this lady that provide us with the biscuits. So with the social events, we get to know more people, especially from those corporate service. So we can get to know people that is outside our group.
During the tea break time, so you will come out, then in the common area, then we maybe can have a discussion.
I know that without the people, you wouldn't get anywhere. So I'm proud of the people that we brought in, and maybe they're still the backbone of IMRE. If that's the case, I have a lot to be very proud of.
IMRE today could not be more different from the IMRE 25 years ago. Over the years, IMRE has made immense strides in developing world-class intellectual and physical infrastructure with enabling technologies in support of growing Singapore's advanced manufacturing and knowledge industries. IMRE is now at the vanguard of materials discovery and innovation, vibrant, alive, and throbbing with ideas.
These young researchers and their collaborative spirit became a cornerstone of IMRE's progress towards achieving its vision. And under their guiding hands, IMRE would transform into an institution capable of competing and collaborating with the global science community.
My vision was to coming into IMRE from ASTAR was to enable, develop IMRE into the institute that would be that integrative element that allows materials research to flow and support a large spectrum of ASTAR capabilities. With that sort of capabilities, we were able to play our role in attracting large multinationals to invest in Singapore.
Yeah, so I'm Johnson. I joined IMRE since 2006 after my PhD. And my first boss that I worked for was Cedric.
I came here from UK. So that was good change of scenery.
Since that time, I have been in and out of research. I went between management and research, and that's where I met both of you.
I joined IMRE first of all as a postgrad student back in July 2002. So I was fortunate enough because my PhD supervisor, Dr. Pan Chi Sen, he was happened to be my so-called advisor during my role in SNC at the moment.
I must admit, one of the things that attracted me to IMRE at that time was the hospitality they extended to me, you know, the personal touch, and you know, we call each other by name, right? Mm-hmm. And there's no addressing of professor and sir. And when I first came to IMRE, what really impressed me was we have a lot of facilities, yes. So many facilities, and we're like kids in the Wonderland, right? Playing with all the fancy scientific tools.
And most importantly, they are all open and sharing. It's no one has particular equipment to his own research group.
Yeah, and I think this is thanks to the planning of our generation before, right, who put those things in place. Mm. When you start as a new scientist, you are actually quite clueless as to how to get this done. And I think thanks to a lot of mentorship and a lot of example experience, PIs who have shown us the way, right? And plus of course a lot of hard knockings ourselves. Cedric gave me a lot of opportunities, a lot of leeway to try new things, a lot of challenges as well, so difficult ones. I think through that we grew. It's always a continuous journey of adaptation, learning to adapt with the changing environment. And I think that's what built us, actually.
I feel the so 20 years, what I feel from IMRE is actually is a freedom to innovate. I think all the department heads or division heads or even the EDs, they allow us to try. Like I remember when I tried to go into this sustainability, it's very new and they still give me a hand and support and resources. And now I'm working as a program lead for these sustainability projects.
That's when we could do research and develop on something, building the capability. And I think it was quite formative years for everything that we've done after it.
Definitely.
It's all, we go with the flow, but with a purpose in what we are doing.
There's an opportunity as well as a training and coaching. Giving to the young staff over here so that they can progress their career and also the opportunity to pursue their interests of research.
We now have a very strong research ecosystem in material science, one of the best in the world. IMRE has opportunity to be the integrator, to be the institute that brings engineering into material science and use that capability to support industry development in Singapore.
Having taken these steps to grow, IMRE began seeking out a strong core of homegrown talents to cultivate and nurture.
IMRE to me is science and people. So first, the science must be deep, must be novel, must be important. And then using science to develop people. And this is why the vision of IMRE is quite clear. You want to have a platform as a material science, as a research organization, people coming to IMRE develop deep capabilities in materials, whether it's scientists or technologists or engineers, and eventually apply to a range of problems, whether it's public problems or industrial problems. And this is very important for IMRE's vision. I always look for people, good people, young people, and people who have the desire to learn, who want to do good science, who want to do something exciting, do something that maybe no one tried before, be more adventurous, prepare to learn, prepare to fail, and prepare to make mistakes and move on and try to make a better life for everybody tomorrow.
The most enjoyable part of being an IMRE is the opportunity to work with lots of talented and excellent scientists and engineers, all of whom wanted to make an impact in technology through their materials know-how.
Yeah, so I joined from right after NTU. So I think 1 year earlier,
one or
I
two
graduated.
Years. Right? Yeah. I joined in 2010.
Yeah, but you all know each other since like...
Oh, during our undergrad days, we already know each other.
I remember some days I have to spend in the labs in NUS. And this lab is, to me, it's very calming. So I work a lot in the dark lab. I really enjoy that time. It gives me a sense of calmness.
Okay. So you like to work in the dark?
Yeah, exactly. I was that time I really liked to work on in the dark. So when I was offered the opportunities to do more things like presenting in front of people, talking to more people, I had to adapt.
Okay.
Quite a bit, right? To do all those kind of different types of roles. When I look back at my journey, right, slowly from one department and now for the entire institutes, right? So I thought it really gives me that, enlarged that view. Yeah, and I'm very happy that everyone actually supported me, right? We're actually very supportive.
I have to agree that we all have similarities in terms of how we have evolved. So for me, right, when I started off as a researcher, my career goals were mainly focused or centered around my own technical achievements. Those were my career goals at that time. My role, I'm sure, similar to both of you, have expanded to include people development.
Yes.
But I think I had a lot of guidance and good mentorship from my bosses and supervisors. They always remind me and taught me about the importance of, you know, building a collaborative community, always prioritizing the success of the entire team and the department over or instead of just focusing on the success of, you know, selected individuals.
When I first joined IMRE and when I have my first session with Jinghua, he summarized that in four Chinese characters. He mentioned Wo Hu Chang Long. That is exactly what it means. IMRE is a place full of talent. In a place like this, we will be able to learn from everyone so long we keep an open mind. But I guess in IMRE, with those different talents coming in, we are enjoying and benefiting from this diverse pool of people.
Now, leaving IMRE was one of the most difficult moments in my life. You know, you left a place that you enjoy working in, and you left the people that you enjoy working with. You can imagine that was a difficult decision. But nevertheless, I left. Probably the most memorable moment, well, maybe my proudest moment was that I was able to, I think, get people together, work as a team, develop the confidence in doing what they do and the pleasure and enjoy what they are doing. And I think working as a team together, as an organization, that was a very proud moment for me. So when I left in a team that believed in themselves, and a team that believed that they can do big things in the years to come without me. That's very important. At the end, we had a good picture with the staff. I think we have a farewell picture. It was outside the IMRE. Over 150 staff came out and took a picture with me before I left. I thought that was memorable. And the picture is in my office today. I think it's the people that make the difference out at the end.
I am most proud when my colleagues get recognized for their work, either by the research community or by industry partners. It is my hope that IMRE can continue to pick out the niche areas that create value in a better and more sustainable way.
As a new day dawns, a new generation of young scientists have emerged to succeed the pioneers who have paved the way for them.
We have started to focus on three key areas, And these are in the areas of optics, in the areas of quantum, and of course in sustainability. The current generation of scientists in IMRE, they are a really dynamic bunch. They are very young and very committed. And it is that kind of spirit of endeavor, trying to understand research, trying to understand the problem that they face, that I really admire about them.
Hi everyone, I'm Yang Le from IMRE, and we are from the PROFESS group, and that stands for Printed Organic Flexible Electronics and Sensors group. So our team works on wearable sensing technology, and currently we're focusing on sweat biomarker detection or sweat metabolite detection, or those biomarkers left behind on our skin surface.
Hi, my name is Michelle, and today we are here at the Adaptive Materials Lab. Basically, what we work on is the food waste and biomass waste valorization.
Welcome to Nanophotonic Lab. I am Tony. So in our lab, we study a tiny objective that is 1,000 times smaller than human hair, called nanoantenna. So this nanoantenna can control light, intensity, directionality, and so much more.
Hi, I'm Aaron, and today I'm here with my colleagues Ivan, Krishna, Huang Ting, and Yu. We are a group of physicists at IMRE, and here we hope to study phenomena like teleportation, being in two states at once, being alive and dead at the same time, being able to walk through walls. These are some of the things that we hope we can study.
We have a wearable device designed to be worn on our wrist. Here are some of the other printed variants of our sensor, and it's connected to this app displayed on the app screen here. So we can monitor our metabolite concentrations in real time and continuously as the user wears our device.
One of the main important criteria that you need to be able to study quantum physics is to be able to achieve extreme temperatures. And here what you see, this system, it's a dilution refrigerator. And with this refrigerator, we can cool samples to an astoundingly low temperature of minus 273 degrees Celsius. Now that's 3 degrees Celsius colder than outer space.
So the technologies that we are developing can potentially make this type of device as small as the glasses that I'm wearing right now.
So here today, for example, I have the spent coffee grounds. So from here, we can work towards creating value-added products such as the chest pieces here. So these are made from bioplastics incorporated with food waste and biomass waste. And beyond that, we move forward to creating different colors of particles.
As the population grows towards being more health conscious, our devices can help us shift that focus towards home-based or at-home monitoring.
So all the efforts here are working towards the sustainable future.
It will bring a true metaverse experience to the user. This will also completely change the way we interact with computer.
And with that, we hope to be able to study devices with functionalities have never been seen before, materials with exotic properties that far exceeds anything that we have today.
Take four.
I've been at IMRE for about 5 years, since 2017. But my association with IMRE actually goes much earlier back. I was here as a research student for my FYP in 2012. And then from 2012 to 2013, I was here for a whole year doing my research attachment.
I joined IMRE 4.5 years ago, although my first engagement here was also quite a while back in 2011 to 2012, before my PhD. Actually, it was back then that I made my first batch of IMRE friends, and they lasted even till today. Our friendship also extends beyond just our scientific work. So I got to know this group of ultra-talented people in A-Star. So they're called the Lab Rats, which is the music band of A-Star. Recently, I started to participate in a few of their performances, did a couple of songs with them. It's a very fun experience, very interesting as well, and great to get to know this bunch of people outside my immediate research group. Yeah,
I joined IMRE back in 2017, much like you guys. But I first started out as a student in 2015 as a FYP student.
I joined DSI back in August 2017. And then in 2018, our whole department moved to IMRE. So right now, I am the team leaders of a group called Novel Light Source. In our department, we have a beer every week. We chat about life, we chat about work. I think all of that experience like make me feel like IMRE is not just a workplace for me. I feel like a family. I feel very lucky to be in such an environment. I really hope and I dream of having a first Nobel Prize winners in the next 25 years of IMRE. And I do really hope that this comes true. So it will be a glory not only for ISTAR but also for Singapore.
I do hope that for IMRE, we can work towards global recognition. You hope we're going to get Nobel Prize in the next 25 years. So I'll look at you three.
I hope in the future, IMRE will be the superstar of ASTAR, a scientific superstar. Yep.
I hope that in the next 25 years, IMRE can only get stronger as an ecosystem leader and an enabler of future technologies that will impact and inspire the world. To all the IMREans, I would like to say thank you very much for the last 2 years, and I look forward to everybody's contribution in the future.
IMRE was born with a mission to become a global leader in material innovation and has grown not only through the tireless passion of our researchers and scientists, but through the connections they have made. And although the sun set on another day at IMRE, we do not see an organization entering its twilight, but instead a family of collaborators and friends boldly taking their next step into the future.
I really hope that our future generation will continue to stay resilient, prioritize teamwork and collaboration, and also continue the good work that our past leaders and alumni have started.
I want to encourage our younger colleagues to keep trying, never give up.
IMRE has changed a lot in just the 5 years that I've been here. And I hope it continues to change, but in a good way, and to continue to engage the next generation of scientists, students, to get them interested in science, like what it did for me.
A future promising a place for all of us to call home. A future of transformation and collaboration as we elevate one another to new heights. A future defined by us.
Impact.
Adaptive.
To inspire.
Create better world. Nobel Prize winning.
Best in the world.
Don't pay no mind to the time.
this place.